Hello, I'm Tatiana Itzkevich, Senior Solutions Architect in AWS. Today, I will show you how to use AWS ResourceOrgID Global Condition Key to help ensure that your identities and your networks can only be used to access trusted resources. When you store your sensitive data in your corporate environment, which may include on-premises networks and AWS clouds, you would want to prevent this data from making its way out of that network to untrusted locations. Untrusted or external locations usually refer to resources which do not belong to your AWS organization. Those are S3 buckets, SNS topics, and other resources that do not belong to your organization boundary. To achieve that objective, you can use AWS and access management capabilities to restrict your IAM principles, such as IAM roles, from making API calls to resources outside of your AWS account or AWS organization. Historically, you could do that by listing out individual resources in IAM policies with ARNs, Amazon resource names, containing the account IDs you won't limit access to. You could also use service-specific condition keys such as S3 resource account to limit access to resources inside your trusted AWS accounts. Notice that in both cases, you have to individually list account IDs in resource or condition element of the policy in order to identify resources that belong to your trust boundary. Even though that allows you to meet the requirement of restricting access to trusted resources, this approach presents scaling challenges for organizations with many accounts created dynamically on a regular basis. Alternatively, you can use IAM global condition keys such as AWS resource account, AWS resource org path, and AWS resource org ID, which consistently apply to all AWS services that support them and can be implemented at an organization level. AWS resource org ID condition key specifically is beneficial for multi-account environments as it allows you to build a boundary at the level of an entire organization. Consider a scenario where you want to prevent your principals from writing to an S3 bucket that is outside of your organization. To accomplish this, you can write a policy which includes the AWS resource org ID condition key with the value set to your AWS organization ID. With this policy in place, when a principal in your organization tries to write to an S3 bucket, AWS verifies if the value of the condition key matches the organization ID of the S3 bucket getting accessed. And if those values do not match, the access will be explicitly denied with this policy. You can apply this policy to any principal in your organization or to your entire organization using service control policies, SCPs. By attaching this policy as an SCP, permissions automatically apply as your organization scales and you add more principals to your AWS environment. This establishes a data perimeter around all principals in your organization and allows to maintain central access control while giving developers ability to innovate and move fast. To illustrate how to use AWS resource org ID in practice, let's go over a couple of use cases. In the first example, I will use an SCP to show you how to implement a data perimeter that helps ensure that your principals cannot upload data to AWS Secrets Manager secrets created outside of your organization. In my second example, I will use a VPC endpoint policy to show you how to create a data perimeter that helps ensure that your networks cannot be used to upload data to Amazon SNS topics created outside of your organization. To demonstrate how you can use SCP to restrict access to AWS Secrets Manager secrets, I will first show you a secret which I have pre-created outside of my AWS organization. You will see that this secret explicitly allows my application role to put secret values. When we navigate to an account the application role belongs to, you will see that this role has Secrets Manager and SNS permissions granted using an identity-based policy. Now, I would like to use application role to update a value of previously shown secret. You can see that this cross-account call has succeeded. In order to apply organization-level control to prevent this type of access, I will navigate to the AWS Organizations Console and create a Deny List SCP. This SCP will result in an explicit deny for put secret value operation if secrets that are being accessed don't belong to my organization. Like all SCPs, this SCP doesn't grant any access, but it establishes a perimeter which is the maximum access allowed to all principals within your organization. Additionally, for a permission to be enabled for a principal in an organization, every SCP from the root through each OU in the direct path to the account must allow that permission. Therefore, besides this deny statement in your SCP, you also need to have an allow list which would define permissions that can be delegated to principals within individual accounts. By default, AWS Organizations attaches an AWS managed SCP named Full AWS Access to every root organizational unit and an account. When I attach this newly created deny list SCP to my OU, these two policies in combination will ensure that my principals are permitted to perform all actions allowed by the identity or resource-based policies, but I explicitly denied put secret value when it is targeting resource outside of my organization. You can also modify this SCP to use a policy variable instead of a hard-coded value for the AWS organization ID. Policy variables is a feature that allows you to specify placeholders in a policy. When a policy is evaluated, policy variables are replaced with values that come from the context of the request itself. In this example, we can use AWS Principal Org ID to derive a value for the AWS Resource Org ID condition key. AWS Principal Org ID value in a request will include the identifier of the organization to which the request in principle belongs. As a result, this policy denies access to put secret value unless the secret being accessed is in the same organization as the IAM principal that is accessing it. The use of this policy variable in this case may simplify your SCP's management when you operate multiple AWS organizations. To show this SCP in action, I will try to access that same secret that belongs to an external account. You can see that I'm getting an access denied this time with a detailed message saying that there is an explicit deny in an SCP preventing this operation. Now, if I try to access a secret which belongs to my organization, I'm able to do so successfully. To summarize, using AWS Resource OrgID condition key within a service control policy, you can create a resource data perimeter around your corporate data, helping to assure that your principals can only access resources in your organization. As my second example, I would like to demonstrate how you can use VPC endpoint policy to prevent principals in your network from accessing SNS topics outside of your organization. I will first show you an SNS topic that I have pre-created in an external account. You see that this topic explicitly allows my application role to publish messages to this topic. You already know that the application role has SNS permissions. Now, I will try to publish to that SNS topic from an EC2 instance running in a VPC of my AWS organization's account. To do so, I will go to the EC2 console and use AWS SSM Session Manager to access that instance. From there, I will issue AWS SNS publish call. You can see that this cross-account call has succeeded. In order to apply guardrail to prevent this type of access, I will navigate to the VPC console. As you may know, you can use VPC endpoints to enable connections between your virtual private cloud and supported services without requiring that you use an internet gateway or a NAT device. By default, VPC endpoints allow full access to the services they are created for. When you create or modify an endpoint, you can attach your custom policy to restrict access through that endpoint based on your security requirements. I will now attach my data perimeter policy to the VPC endpoint for SNS service. This policy will ensure that SNS actions are only allowed if topic specified in the request belongs to my organization. Like SCPs, VPC endpoint policies do not grant any access, but rather establish a boundary, which is the maximum access allowed through that endpoint. Please note that when you use AWS ResourceOrgID condition key in a VPC endpoint policy, we do not recommend using a policy variable instead of a hard-coded value for the AWS organization ID. This is to prevent malicious users from bringing their own credentials into your network and trying to exfiltrate data by uploading it to their resources. In this scenario, AWS principal ORGID value in the request context will be the malicious user's organization ID. And therefore, if you use principal ORGID variable in this policy, you will permit that user to access resources outside of your organization. You can, however, mitigate this risk by applying another IAM global condition key to this policy, AWS principal ORGID, which will restrict all SNS actions to principals in your AWS organization only. This creates a defense in depth protection against data exfiltration. To show this VPC endpoint policy in action, I will try to access the SNS topic that belongs to an external organization from that same EC2 instance running in my VPC. You see that now I'm getting an access denied for this request with a detailed error message saying that VPC endpoint policy not allowing this access. And if I try to publish to an SNS topic which belongs to my organization, I'm able to do so successfully. To summarize, using AWS ResourceOrgID condition key within a VPC endpoint policy, you can create a resource data perimeter around your corporate data, helping to ensure that your networks can only be used to access resources in your organization. Please note that there are scenarios when AWS services act on your behalf, accessing resources that do not belong to your AWS organization. Such data access patterns should be accounted for when implementing ResourceOrgID condition key in policies in your production environment. This should be dictated by your use of AWS services and expected data access patterns. Please reference individual services documentation for more details. You have just seen how you can use AWS ResourceOrgID global condition key to simplify policies while limiting access to trusted resources. Thank you for watching.